أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم عم يتساءلون عن النبأ العظيم الذي هم فيه مختلفون كلا سيعلمون ثم كلا سيعلمون ألم نجعل الأرض مهادا والجبال أوتادا وخلقناكم أزواجا وجعلنا نومكم سباتا وجعلنا الليل لباسا وجعلنا النهار معاشا وبنينا فوقكم سبعا شدادا وجعلنا سراجا وهاجا وأنزلنا من المعصرات ماء ثجاجا لنخرج به حبا ونباتا وجنات ألفافا إن يوم الفصل كان ميقاتا يوم ينفخ في الصور فتأتون أفواجا وفتحت السماء فكانت أبوابا وسيرت الجبال فكانت سرابا إن جهنم كانت مرصادا للطاغين مآبا لابثين فيها أحقابا لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا إلا حميما وغساقا جزاء وفاقا إنهم كانوا لا يرجون حسابا وكذبوا بآياتنا كذابا وكل شيء أحصيناه كتابا فذوقوا فلن نزيدكم إلا عذابا إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن لا يملكون منه خطابا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يوم ينذر المرء ما قدمت يداه ويقول الكافر يا ليتني كنت ترابا صدق الله العظيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونسلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم إلى آخره الحمد لله Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided another chance in our life to welcome Ramzan al-Mubarak. I congratulate all brothers and sisters for having Ramzan al-Mubarak. Ramzan al-Mubarak is a month of blessing. Ramzan al-Mubarak is a month of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ramzan al-Mubarak is a month of Quran. Ramzan al-Mubarak is a month of patience. Quran revealed in this month. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to recite Quran Kareem in the month of Ramzan, especially in front of Jibreel Amin. Whatever the portion was revealed, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited in front of Jibreel, and Jibreel again recited the Quran in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is why this is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to recite the whole Quran in the month of Ramzan in Salatul Tarawih. Those who cannot recite, for them this is the sunnah to listen, to offer Salatul Tarawih and to listen the whole Quran. There are two different sunnah. One sunnah, reciting or listening Quran. Another sunnah, offering Salatul Tarawih. Whatever the portion will be recited in the night, inshallah, we will try to present the gist of the portion of the Quran. Today is the first Ramzan Mubarak. Last night it was recited Suratul Fatiha and some portion of Suratul Baqarah. Suratul Fatiha is a Makki surah and Suratul Baqarah is Madani surah. The difference between Makki and the Madani, the portion of the Quran that revealed before the migration to Medina, that is called the Makki. The portion that is revealed after the migration to Medina, that is called Madani. In the whole Quran, there are 6,236 verses and there are 114 chapters. Out of 114 chapters, 86 surah revealed in Makkatul Mukarma and 28 surah revealed after migration to Medina Munawwara. And most of the surah are Makki, and the Makki surah gives us the lesson of Tawheed, oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the lesson of creed of prophethood, Risala, the lesson and the guidance about the day of judgment, and the answers of the question of mushrikeen, non-believer, about the life after death. And in the Madani surah, most of the subject that is discussed, that is about the daily life, the family life, the spiritual life of a Muslims. Suratul Fatiha, the name of the Fatiha shows this is the first surah. Fatiha means the beginning, starting, because this is the surah that you start Quran Kareem. This is the surah that is recited in the prayers, in all the prayers, five times prayer. If you offer five time prayers, then at least 20 times you have to offer Suratul Fatiha in the all rak'ah. Because Huzur sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La salata illa bi fatihatil kitab. No prayer can be accepted unless the person who is offering the prayer, he recites Suratul Fatiha. If someone is offering the prayer behind the imam, if imams recite Suratul Fatiha, that is sufficient for the person who is behind the imam. But if someone is offering the prayer individually, then he has to read, he has to recite Suratul Fatiha in each rak'ah of the prayer. And Fatiha is the gist of the whole Quran. In the whole Quran, most important subject that is discussed in the whole Quran, that is the subject of Tawheed, oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the subject of the Risala, the subject of the Qiyamah, the last day, and the subject of the guided people who are the model for the people, for the Ummah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discussed the whole Quran but presented in a short in Suratul Fatiha. Suratul Fatiha is given different name. The one name is Al-Fatiha and other name is Shafiya, As-Sab'ul Masani, Suratul Kanz, Suratul Hamd, Ummul Quran. Means foundation, because this is the foundation of the Quran. Sab'i Masani, about that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I have been given Sab'i Masani, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Suratul Hijr, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي. We have given you seven repeated verses, and that is Suratul Fatiha. And this is the Shafia, because this gives a spiritual strength to the believers. And that is why this is most important surah. About that, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is the greatest surah of the Quran. And another surah is Suratul Baqarah. Suratul Baqarah is the most lengthy surah of the Quran. It has 286 verses. This is the surah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discussed different topic and subject in the surah. The name of the surah, Baqarah. Baqarah means the cow. Because in this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has stated the story of Bani Israel. And that is story related to a cow. So that is why the surah has been given the name Al-Baqarah. And in the all surah of the Quran, the name of the surah doesn't speak the topic, the subject of the surah. Maybe some topic is discussed in few verses, but the name was given the whole surah. So Suratul Baqarah starts with Alif Lam Mim. And this surah about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is the protection from shaitan. And if this surah is recited in any house, that house is protected from shaitan. So this is the surah that gives us the lot of knowledge about the family life of a Muslim. In this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has discussed different topic about the Hajj, fasting, about the prayers. And this surah tells us how men behave with his wife and what is the obligations and responsibilities of a wife upon husband, the rights and the obligation of husband upon wife. So this is the surah. In the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the qualities of a believers and also the qualities of non-believer and the qualities of hypocrites, munafiq. This surah that tells us the story of Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, the first man and the first prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this surah also tells us when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased, those who perform the good action, good deeds in here, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide them paradise, Jannah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the qualities of a believer, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ, those who believe on unseen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot be seen in this life. The qiyamah cannot be seen. Jannat cannot be seen. Jahannam cannot be seen. A Muslim, a believer has to believe in them, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described in the holy book Al-Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this surah for the guidance and for the guidance of the whole ummah. So that is why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, because he was sending some delegation and for the jihad, then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was deciding a leader for this group. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, anyone who knows something from the Quran? A sahabi, a companion, raised the hand and said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I knew the Suratul Baqarah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam appointed him as a leader of the group. It means if someone knows the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is described in Suratul Baqarah, he is able to lead the community. He is able to lead the groups, the Muslims, people. So this is an important surah that we have to recite, and we have to learn whatever the lesson Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described in it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the right path, the path of Quran Kareem. Wa ma alayna illa al-balaghul mubin.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana li hadha wama kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala sayidina Muhammad وعلى آل محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر لي ولوالدي ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم تقبل منا صلاة اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا في هذا الشهر شهر رمضان وتقبل منا صلاتنا صلاة التراويح وبارك لنا ويسر أمورنا وزدنا علما وإيمانا وتقوى يان سيدي جوا كاو لي ساي ngomun tik sam ling jip kan lei chen sen gun ju yi kin sen hyang lei zang mei lei ki lim lei gam jie lei ju a kaw lei jip sao ngomun di zai gai lai bai tomai ki tou o yan chi di ju a kaw lei sai ngomun di zai gai bu gan gan hai gai shi gai yin gai mai fu chai geng ga hai gai yi yun gai che nim gai che si gai yi chai yin hei zui ngo di si qing ju a kou li zheng qiang wo men di xun yang zheng qiang wo men dui li di xun cong ngai tong mai geng wei Allahumma amin.